Welcome to Feller Talk, Fellers. In this episode of this fellery feller, this feller right here is wearing a brown shirt. This is my favorite shirt so far right now that I think I've ever owned. To be honest, to be fair, it's a great shirt. This is episode 2 of Feller Talk, part 2, season 2, whatever. Yeah, just thought you guys would love that. But we're going to start off this episode. We got some topics, but first I want to start off with sweet tea. It's just the best. I think it really deserves the Sweet Tea Louisiana Award. Whoever invented made sweet tea, stunning. I'm not talking about unsweet tea. If you like unsweet tea, you're old. I'm kidding. You're not old. Chill out. Got a little sweaty for a minute, but you're not old. You're just uncultured if you like unsweet tea. And that's okay if you do, because my grandfather, he's a great man. He likes unsweet tea. I respect him for what he likes, but unsweet tea is unbearable to me. Let's get into the topics. I hope you guys are doing well, by the way. All right, first topic. Is this even supposed to be on here, John?
John,
come on, man. Remember, I told you this was a TV-14 business here. I told you nothing rated R, okay? It's supposedly TV-14. We could talk about this? Okay. Well, if John says you can talk about it, you can talk about it. So, why don't we get started? Is it getting hot in here? Man, it's a strong topic. What are my thoughts on strip clubs? Well... Man, it's a wild topic. Let me take a sip of my sweet tea first. Wise choice of words. The strip clubs are nice. They're filled with wonderful Christian-ish women. On the side note, maybe not the Christian part, but wonderful, wonderful people. Wonderful. Have I been to one? No. No, not yet. No. No, I have not. We're not even going to get into that. Next topic. What is by far Dylan's favorite martial art weapon? Good question. Now, that is a question I can't answer. I would say right now, it would have to be the size. If you don't know what a sai is, pull up a picture right there. Those, my friend, are size. And they're really nice. Mine are only about, 12 inches long. They're not that... That's what she said, 12 inches long. But, they curve out like this, and they're just... You can kind of pin them against people, bring them down to the ground, then bam, stab them. We're not going to get into that. But basically what you can do is a lot of things with it. You can defend yourself by turning it around, flipping it face forwards, and let me just show you what you can do with it, my friend. You can do this. This right here is the sai. Magnificent creature of a friend, if I will say so. I will say so myself. All right, so what you want to do, move this chair out for a second. Not really the office studio to be doing this, but you want to take it. Take your sai, okay? Let me just get two of them. Might as well, right, while you're at it. Okay, so you have the normal stance, okay? You've got this right here. This is how you hold them. Computer's going dark again. This is how you hold them. Thumb like this, hand like this. Grip on, grip off. That's what she said. Okay, so what you do, you can do this, but... How you want to start, and here's how you flip them, okay? You flip them like this to block this off right here. You want to block this. So if somebody comes behind you, let's say this is a sword, hi-ya-ha! You can block them like this, and it will protect your forearm from being hit. Okay, so really useful. Pop them in, pop them out. Yeah! Saya! 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 You know, intense. So pop them in. Something I've recently learned, let me move this chair a little bit. A move I've recently learned is I call it the cat paw. But you go like this, step forward, flip, step back,
Saya! Saya!
So, these are my favorite martial art weapons for right now. There's a lot of martial art weapons. I'm really a big fan of katanas. The bow staff is honestly Dylan's iconic weapon. Love the bow staff, but sometimes the bow staff is not very useful, if you know what I mean. It will knock the absolute shit out of somebody, but it can't kill anybody, so... I wouldn't kill anybody ever, but, like, if you're trying to face them off or whatever. Size are great, that's all I gotta say. Okay, back to the office studio, where we can actually talk about things and not have to fight our way through stuff. The third topic, the world as a whole. Wow, that is a big topic. The world as a whole is a topic I can go day on and day forward to, is basically what I mean to say. The world as a whole. Now, I can't really tell you my intentional thoughts, my real thoughts on this topic, but I could say this. John picked these topics out. John's behind the screens there. John's he's the one that writes my topics down for the episodes. There's normally about four or five he writes down. This episode, there's only four. We may create five. Who knows? Who knows how long we feller talk for? But the world as a whole. So I think the government is hiding a bunch of things. Now you can disagree with me, but all the little coincidences that happen with your Alexas, like, randomly popping on and listening to you, like why and where and what just happened. And you know when you talk about things and, like, suggested things that you've been talking about will pop up on your Google search, like, that kind of weird stuff? Yeah. And all the stuff with the hiding of the aliens and the Martians and whatever, that, you know, all these little UFO sightings and footages that the government randomly releases and all that crap. It's weird, but we kind of just, you know, say, let the government do what they want to do. The government is hiding something. I can't tell you what it is because, honestly, I don't know what it is. But that's why I have the Illuminati symbol right here. It's because I never know if I'm ever going to need to talk about that. So in this episode, I will. I don't know much about the Illuminati, but I do know that government hides things from you. I don't know what because they won't ever tell you, but I don't think the president really knows. Like, I don't think Biden or Trump or, you know, Kamala Harris or, you know, presidents we've had. Who's the president beforehand? Obama. I don't think anybody knew, you know, George W. Bush. I don't think anybody knew what the government did. And, you know, they say presidents are part of the government. That's true. But I think the presidents are more of the presidents and the vice presidents. I think they're more of a show that TV and all the nation's essentials can see. Counting the queens and stuff, if you live in the UK, you know, Wales or, you know, England, whatever, Europe, all that's good stuff. And you've got all these, you know, princes, kings, and queens, and you got the presidents and the states and stuff. They're just the big show. They come on TV, they tell you what's up, you know, they give a long speech or whatever. But the government is what hacks, is what does all the computer-generated work. They're the ones that basically run the system. They know what's really up with the world, but they won't tell anybody, obviously. So that's my thoughts on the world right now. The world as a whole right now, with coronavirus going on and everything, it's a crazy world. I can't tell you, you know, how some dude ate a bat from China. Not trying to be racist at all. Don't cancel me. But that's just how it went down, I guess. But who knows? And now they're creating robots, for God's sakes. I mean, I see on TikTok, well, there's like robots now. People go and visit. And they're like female robots or whatever. They're bald heads. And they look at you and smile and talk to you and stuff. That's crazy to me. That's honestly insane. Insane. Last topic for the day. Random fact of the day. I'm going to start doing these every filler talk. Basically what it is, I've got this big book my grandfather gave me, and it's a bunch of, oh God, that's the camera. It's a bunch of, you know, just out of the blue, ordinary facts that you would never really think that anybody would ever really, anyways, I'll show you the book right now. Here's what it looks like. You've probably seen it before. I think you can get it on Amazon. I don't know how much it is. The Book of Unusual Knowledge. It says it took about 3 million hours for Stone Age workers to build Stonehenge. That picture right there, it took them 3 million hours to build that. That's just a fact on the front cover. We haven't even gotten to the real pages yet. Anyways, let's skim through the book. Whatever page I land on is whatever page we're getting out of. Okay. Alright, so I don't like that page. Honestly, I really just don't like it. Betty Crocker. Let's start off with a Betty Crocker fun fact. How about it? You know, Betty Crocker. The brand of the cake mix and stuff. You know who Betty Crocker is. Betty Crocker. Thousands of letters were sent to General Mills in the 1920s, all asking for answers to baking questions. To give the responses a personal touch, the company's managers created a fictional character. The surname Crocker was chosen to honor a retired executive, and Betty was selected because it seemed warm and friendly. In the 1930s, an artist, Naza McMahon, blended the faces of several female employees to create a likeness. Crocker's face has changed many times over the years. She's been made to look younger. What a fun fact. You know, I didn't know that about Betty Crocker. I mean, I know she was like the face of a... But I didn't know she was like computer generated to like, you know, look younger and stuff. That is awesome. You know, computers are crazy. I can't believe it. But awesome. Awesome fun fact of the day. Never knew that about Betty Crocker. Wow. Betty. Not Betty White, because God rest her soul, she passed away. But Betty Crocker, that's awesome. Betty Crocker had a child, and his name was Dan Crocker. I don't really know. But anyways, that's all the topics I got today. That's all that John wrote. So I can't really think of anything else to talk about. So I'm guessing I'll be out. So I'll see you guys later. Hope you guys have a great rest of your night, great rest of your afternoon, great rest of your morning. Have a cup of coffee or sweet tea. In this case, enjoy your Lucille bat, Colin, pound it in. We're going to call it a night. See you, fellas. I listen to the wind of my soul. Where I'll end up, well, I think only God really knows. I've sat upon the setting sun, but never, 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 never. I never wanted water once. Never, never, never. I listen to my words, but they fall far below. I let my music take me where my heart wants to go. I swam upon the devil's lake, but never, 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 I'll never make the same mistake.